everybody. I'm Pranav Nissan, and today I'll be talking about the book called The Authenticity Project by Claire Cooley. I mentioned this book in my TBR video, and I finished reading it as soon as the video went up. That's like a 3 weeks or 2 weeks ago, I think. And I didn't have a moment to sit down and talk about it, so I finally found the time to do it, and here we are. So The Authenticity Project, as the name indicates, is based around the theme of authenticity and honesty among people. So in The Authenticity Project, there's a tiny little book, book called The Authenticity Project. In that, an 80-year-old man called Julian writes his life story completely honestly. And if you read that part of the book, you'll understand why he acts a certain way or why he is in a certain way like that. And he leaves this book in a restaurant, in a cafe called Monica's Cafe, so that other people would pick it up and write their stories and be completely honest in the book. Not to anyone in particular, but to the book. So Monica from Monica's Cafe picks up the book and she reads his story, and she's so moved by the thought of being honest and authentic. She writes her story in it and she leaves it in a bar. So this small book circulates around the city, around the world actually, and brings six people together and forms unlikely friendships, unexpected friendships and romances, and it just brings people together. So that is the theme of this book, how honesty and authenticity brings people or things together. So I read this about 3 weeks ago. I listened to the audiobook version of it. I'll put a video of how to find the free audiobook here. You can enjoy it for absolutely free. It's available on Amazon also for 400 rupees, I think. So after reading this book, it took me 2 days to finish it, and I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars, which is rather disappointing, because when I first came across this book, everyone was like, this is the best feel-good book of 2020. It's so amazing, you're going to love it, it's going to be the best feel-good book or story you ever come across, and it was not like that for me. So when I started reading it, it had a good start, because you get to know the story of Julian, who is an 80-year-old painter and a widower. He just lost his wife, he lost his wife 15 years ago. So he's kind of an extreme introvert since his wife died, and he never cherished her properly when she was alive. So you see his regret at one side of the story. Then you see Monica, who's like a perfectionist, to the level of obsessive cafe owner. She was a lawyer who turned into an entrepreneur. And you see her story and how she's dealing with loneliness and such. You see the story of everybody, and there are such diverse characters. But as the story keeps progressing and all these unique characters come together, it becomes repetitive, because I felt that this book didn't have to be so long. It's not long at all. It's like average 300 to 400 pages length. But it felt very draggy, and it didn't have to be so draggy. The author went into unnecessary explanations of every single thing and every single emotion they felt. I know this is like a feel-good book where you explore all your feelings and emotions, but this kind of felt repetitive and not much of feel-good things. It was feel-good for up to 40%, and 60% of it was like a messy rom-com. Like, things suddenly go wrong and then you just talk to each other and they become right again and everyone's happy. So it just felt like a very cheesy rom-com at some point. And I don't know about the feel-good part. I mean, every rom-com is feel-good. This is feel-good too, but not up to the extent of the best book of 2020. So the best feel-good book of 2020. So that is how I felt about it, and I think you should give it a try. And maybe you would like it more than I did, because lakhs of people on Goodreads found it amazing. I'm just one of those people who didn't find it so good, but it is still a good book nonetheless, because it has great writing, a great theme to it, and an explore worthy author. So I hope, despite my disappointment with this book, you would pick this book up and try it, since it's available for free and audiobooks are the second best way to read the book. So now that we've got the review done, let's talk about what I'm reading currently. So from the past 1 month, I think I'm going through a horrible reading slump. I haven't been able to read anything, I mean finish a book completely. I started so many books, like as soon as I finished the Authenticity Project, I think my reading slump started then, because as soon as I finished it, I started reading To Sleep in a Sea of Stars by Christopher Paolini. I read like 1/5 of it and I was instantly hit with this massive horrible reading slump, so I couldn't continue reading it. I put it aside and I thought that maybe a change of genre could bring back my reading game. So I tried many genres. I tried to read thrillers for Halloween, like The Silence of the Lambs, read her, that you know, Hannibal Cannibal series, so even that didn't do anything. I read like, I listened to like 1 hour of the audiobook and I was like off, I'm bored. So there are many books I tried like that, and the book that kind of got me out of my reading slump is The Poppy War. It was absolutely phenomenal. I read it like 2 weeks ago, and The Poppy War is so motivating to, for me it was very motivating, because Poppy War is about war and obviously and preparing for the war, so all the preparation process is super intense and hard working stuff, so that was really motivating, and so that got me a bit out of my reading slump. It was a complete 5 out of 5 The Poppy War. If you haven't read it, the final part of the trilogy is coming, has already come out this year, and I cannot wait to finish the entire trilogy. And right now I'm reading The Last Unicorn. I don't remember the author. I found the audiobook for it on YouTube itself, because the physical copy is around 6,000 rupees. That is absolutely insane. I mean, this book is supposed to be a classic fantasy, like a really old fantasy book, so nobody's really selling it, and the ones who are selling it, like Amazon, are charging 6,000 rupees. And I found a free audiobook version here on YouTube, so I'm like one chapter into it, and so far it's like a fairy tale slash fantasy kind of thing, and I'm into it. So let's see where that goes, or if my reading slump is to continue. And another book I want to get to is The Jade City, but I don't want to start reading it and then get off it in the, because of my reading slump, because Jade City has gotten so many amazing reviews, and I want to read it when I'm completely in the game and I'm like enthusiast about a new book or something. So The Jade City is supposedly a mixture of magic plus Godfather. And what is not to like about magic and Godfather? It sounds absolutely amazing. So I cannot wait to start The Jade City. I mean, as soon as my reading slump is over. And this is exam season right now for me. That didn't help with the reading slump, because I barely have time to make videos, let alone read the entire book. So yeah, I think it will be a proper December until I really get back into my usual reading, like 6 books a month. Like that. So until then, we'll see. I'll just take it slow and focus on my exams for this month, and get back to you when I'm back in the game and with some awesome recommendations. So that's it for this video, and that's the update of my life, kind of update, reading life. So I would love to know what you're reading in the comment section down below. So with that, I'll wrap this up, and until the next video. Bye.